Hey folks, as many of you know, the old version of Google Analytics is going to be expiring very soon. There is a new version called Google Analytics 4 that has been out for about 2 years now, and for many of you that I've been working with are probably in good shape in terms of having that installed on your site. Google has said that the old version of Analytics will stop recording data pretty soon, but that eventually the data that has been recorded historically is going to be erased. And so in this video, I want to talk you through number one, how to prepare for that, how to get your data out of Google Analytics, and then how to make it useful. First, I just want to talk about where are in June 2023. So number one, as I said, Universal Analytics is going to stop processing data as of July 1st, 2023. You may have been getting email warnings. You may have seen things pop up when you get into Universal Analytics. Needless to say, Google is doing a good job of alerting us that this is coming up. GA4 or Google Analytics 4 is the future. This is the new version of analytics that came out, as I said, about a year or two ago, and is going to be the future of where your website analytics lives. The bad news is that the old data that was in Universal Analytics is not being moved into GA4. So we need to pull that information out of Universal Analytics so that we can preserve it and make it useful. As I said, Google has essentially stated as of May 2023 that your data will be available for quote unquote at least 6 months. So that gives us about to the end of the year, according to them. They haven't given a specific date, and we know that more information is coming out, so we'll keep a handle on it. But it doesn't mean we shouldn't start preparing for this process anyway, because it is fairly complicated, and we want to make sure that we can keep our historical data. So, how do we do that, right? I already mentioned a few times that we need to export it out of there. I'm going to give you a couple of ideas around how we're going to do this at Rooted with our clients. And secondly, how do we make it useful, right? As I said before, this stuff is all going to live in a spreadsheet. Your future analytics are going to live in Google Analytics 4. So how do we compare those two things? So I've come up with a system that I can walk you through here and give you a little bit of a sense of how you can go about doing that. So before we get into the actual process, a couple things to consider is you're not going to be able to take all of this data with you. You may have 20 years of Google Analytics website data, and I can guarantee you that out of the hundreds of metrics that are available for you to pull, there may be a bunch that you've never even looked at. So we really need to decide what are the metrics that are going to be important to us in the future, and what are the metrics that we can just say, it's okay if that gets erased. Now, for those of you that are working with Rooted, you may have a measurement plan in place. If you don't, I'd highly recommend thinking about building one. If you need the tool, I'll put a link in this video or in the blog post where this video lives so that you can pull that in and build one if you don't have one already. The other thing is that Google Analytics 4 has some different metrics and different names for their metrics than the old version of analytics. And some of the old metrics in the older version of analytics are just going away altogether. So we want to make sure in this process that we can make sense of comparing apples to apples, not apples to oranges. And I'll talk to you a little bit about how we might want to go through doing that. Thirdly, how far back is useful for your work? Now, if you have 20 years of analytics, I can guarantee you maybe you haven't pulled a report from 2009 or something like that. But I would recommend thinking about only pulling somewhere between 4 or 5 years of analytics. One of the reasons for this is the tools that we're going to be using, they're not industrial level tools. These are things that may have trouble dealing with 20 years of data. And ultimately, if the data is not useful, there's really no reason to go through the process of making it, work for you. So it's just going to be extra time spent on this project. So think about maybe 4, maybe 5 years of analytics. And then lastly here, how long have you been recording in Google Analytics 4? For those of you that have been working with Rooted, I think we got a lot of our clients set up pretty early on. So if you have, a year or two of Google Analytics 4 data, you may not need to go and use that Universal Analytics data. You can just pull historical data that started before the installation of Google Analytics 4. So that might be a way to reduce the amount of data that you need to actually export out of the system. So what tools are we recommending that you use. Number one, fee is great, right? We are all working at nonprofits. We have limited budgets. We're not spending thousands of dollars per month on tools for analytics. So free is really great. Secondly, what's accessible to your team? Google Analytics, or Google rather, has offered a free access to a system they call BigQuery, which is a giant database system that allows you to dump all of your information into. However, it requires you or somebody that you hire to be able to write MySQL code to make any sense of the data that's in there. So I'd really recommend sticking with tools that are really accessible for your team. And that's partly why we recommend using Google Sheets and a system that we like to use to build dashboards called Google Data Studio. And I'll walk you through how to do this in just a second. But Google Sheets is really great. If you were able to pull out a couple years of data, then you'd have no problems with getting that data into Google Sheets. And then in terms of displaying it in reports, Google Data Studio is really effective for that. So what does this project look like in terms of what are the steps? Number one, as I said before, identify the metrics that are useful for you. Use that measurement plan. If you don't have one, consider going through the process with your team of actually building one. We do have 6 months before that data gets erased. So it's a little bit of time for you to get that measurement plan in place. Number two is, after you've identified what metrics that you want to take out of Universal Analytics, go into Universal Analytics, find the report that has that metric in it, and export that data, and then bring it into Google Sheets. I think it's really important to think about your consistent date range, right? As I said, if you want to pull 4 years of data, but your Google Analytics 4 was installed in 2022, then maybe you only need to pull data from 2017 to 2021, right? So for all of the reports that you're going to export that data from, make sure the date ranges are consistent. And then secondly, make sure that the intervals are consistent as well. Google Analytics allows you to pull intervals of daily metrics, weekly metrics, monthly metrics, and annual metrics. So if you're pulling daily metrics for one metric, make sure that you pull daily metrics for the second metric and all the other ones that you're going to pull out of there as well. The third process here, or third step here, is to consolidate and normalize that data. So add all of that stuff that you've exported out of Google Analytics into one Google Sheet if possible, and then do your best, if possible, to match up the names of metrics from Google Analytics 4 with your historical data. So I'll give you an example of this. In Google Analytics 4, there is a metric called views. In Universal Analytics, there was a metric called page views. Those are actually the same thing. They just have different names. So if you export page views out of Universal Analytics, you can just rename it views in your historical data. It's going to make it a lot easier to match that up when it comes time to put that into your dashboard. Okay. And then lastly here, map your Universal Analytics and GA4 data in your dashboard. As I said before, you know, once you get it into Google Sheets, it's actually really easy to use a tool like Google Data Studio in order to match those things up so that you can compare them over time. I wanted to walk you through an example really quickly of how this might work. For those of you that recently attended our workshop about making sense of website metrics, this dashboard is going to be familiar to you. This is a completely made up organization that we used as a case study for the workshop. So this is not real data. This is not a real organization. But as you can see here, we're looking at data from May 2023. This is all Google Analytics 4 data. But let's say that we didn't install Google Analytics 4 on our website until 2022. And I want to pull a report for 2021. So I'm going to come into this dashboard, pull a report for January 1st, and I'm going to pull it through January 31st. As soon as I click here, it refreshes, and now I'm actually using the historic data of Google Analytics here. This is stuff that's being pulled out of my Google Sheet, and if I wanted to, in some ways, I could compare this to the live data in Google Analytics 4 if I wanted to. But again, if I just wanted to look at May 2023, if I refresh my dashboard, it will automatically load that in. So this way, we have continuity from the very beginning of our historical data through the current day, and then into the future. So this is a really quick process of how we make sense of and preserve that really important data that we've been recording on our website for so long, and then bring it into our reporting dashboards. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out. Otherwise, good luck, and hopefully you can make sense of all of this historic data.